All right, if you're looking for information in the Bellevue market in Washington, there's nobody better that I know than Igor Pachowski. Check out this video as Igor gives us up-to-date information on what's going on in the market in Bellevue in this period of COVID and uncertainty. Our house is selling. Is this a good time to sell, a good time to list? Check it out all the way through. Igor presents us with some great data. Hey, welcome again to another What's Going On With Real Estate series, this time with Igor Pachowski of Winderman Real Estate down in Bellevue. Igor, thanks for joining us today. How you doing?
John, thank you for having me. Doing great.
Good. Well, I got to tell you, I'm really interested. We haven't talked in a little while. Things are still uncertain in the COVID-19 and all of that. So let's dive right into this. What's going on in the Bellevue market with real estate, Igor?
You know, I went on a walk with a few friends the other day, and they're not really in the real estate market, but they asked me a question like, oh, like our homes are selling. Are people buying homes? And I thought to myself, well, kind of an odd question, because obviously I'm in the business, but then I thought a little longer and I'm like, well, it makes sense. People don't really know with all of this uncertainty and COVID and everything of what's going on. The reality is the market is extremely hot and it's going bananas right now. So let me explain. Without boring you with too much data, you know, over the springtime, 3 months when COVID just started, right? March, April, May. Those months, we could say it's been pretty dead. The whole business dropped 50%. Can you believe it? Like all of the wow. transactions, 50% of the business had shrank for everyone. And the market still relatively was pretty hot because the inventory still was limited and the amount of buyers that were in the market, they were really motivated buyers. So we still had multiple offers across the board. But now what we are seeing is that activity levels, they are higher than they were at the same time last year. So what I mean by that, Seattle right now is doing 4% over that what they were doing last year, amount of the transactions. Bellevue is booming right now. The east side is 12% over when it was last year with no COVID, right? So the market is doing really, really good in a way. It is not a buyer's friendly market, unfortunately. And the reason for it, there is a very important metric, which is months of inventory. So right now we have 1 month of inventory. What does it mean? That if there is no new listings coming on the market, everything will sell off in 1 month. Okay.
Wow.
So 1 month is a very much seller's market where if it's under 1 month, you know, you see double digit appreciation. 1 month, it's, you know, 5-6% over asking for good listings. If it's been presented well, if it looks good, if it smells good, if it's in a good area, like all of those things, listings do sell within, you know, 5 to 6 days pretty much. So the market been booming. And I should say across the east side altogether on different price points, you know, $1.5-$2 million homes move pretty good. 700,000, 800,000, 900,000 homes are selling quite fast too. So we kind of happen, as you know, interest rates are amazing right now. Like conventional, low balance conventional is around like what right now, 2.75? Well, what is it, John?
Very low. Absolutely. Right down there.
Very low, so, right? Like high balance conventional closer to 3. Jumbo's like 3.5. Like the money are cheap. And people in our area, they make incomes. Like we have right now from latest news, Amazon is moving to Redmond. So they're gonna bring additional 600 employees to downtown Redmond on top of 10,000 employees in downtown Bellevue. So even with COVID and with social distancing and people working remotely, we can talk, there is a lot I have to say about that, but we'll keep it simple. The east side right now is keep on expanding. And I would say if you were thinking to buy, I would probably do it. Even that it's not, you know, buyer friendly market right now, I don't really see unless there is something unseen that we cannot really imagine would happen. Very strong market. It's amazing time to sell for sure. It's still, you can compete in this market. If you have someone who represents you well, you can win in this market because rates are so good. So east side right now, 1 month of inventory, it's hot, and activity is, we're doing more than we did last year with no COVID. That's in short.
That is phenomenal. So guys, you know, Igor hit it really well there. Even though house prices are expensive, and the problem is they're going to probably continue to do that, because what he's articulating here is that there's a very resilient economy down there, you know, with the high tech industry and all of that, it's just strong. So if you want to buy a house, and you look at the other side of the equation, which is the cost of the financing, which Igor touched on there, which is about as low as we've seen it in years and years and years, it's still an extremely good time to buy, because there's two sides. There's the cost of the home and there's the cost of the financing. You put those together, that's the overall cost. And really, it's a great time. So thanks, Igor. Good time to list, it sounds like, if you want to sell. And it's a good time to buy because of the combination of those two.
You're right on. And, you know, we're not being naives, John. Like, I do look at news. I do see everything that is out there. And I hate saying that this is a bulletproof era, because everything has this, like, domino effect, right? Like, everything is connected. But unfortunately, just because inventory is so high, I have a client right now, their combined income is 700,000, you know, 700,000, just think about that number. And there are a lot of them out there. There are a lot of people with everything else that's going on. We do have a ton of people that make good income. Let's just put it this way. And there are five houses for sale. So they want to buy, they can afford it. Real money that they put down, you know, real incomes. And that's just kind of where the market is right now. Coming in the end of the year, we'll see. I don't really see it's kind of slowing anytime soon. Hopefully we will have more inventory, but you know, it's been pretty strong. It kind of happened just like 2-3 weeks ago. I've got like five clients that were waiting to see what happens, jumping back to action. So we'll see. I think it will be a very strong end of the year so far for us.
Well, that, you know, this is positive stuff, guys. I'm good to hear from all of this stuff, Igor. And as he's indicating, guys, you know, there's uncertainty in the market. We don't know exactly what's going to happen. But the fact of the matter is, as everyone kind of agrees, we're going to get through this. This too will pass. Real estate may take a dip. I don't think the data indicates right now it's going to take much of one, if any, especially in the Seattle Bellevue market kind of thing, where there's a high demand right now. So if there's a house you like and financing is cheap, now's not a bad time to take a look at it and talk to Igor and see what's going on there. So Igor, thanks for your time again today. Great data as always. Always appreciate talking with you. We'll keep this up, okay?
John, thank you for having me.
All right. Igor's information could be on the screen, guys. You saw there. If you have any questions, just give him a call or send an email. He demands for Bellevue.